Well, tell me what's going on today.
Well, the Northumberland Players are in their 46th year of operation, and we are opening, having the grand opening of our hub at 450 Campbell Street, which through the generosity of Trillium has finally come to fruition. We have rented this huge space here, all of Unit 3, and it joins our costume house, which is Unit 4. It's a massive space with all of our sets, properties, costumes, paint room, tech room. Everything we ever wanted is here in one space.
Tell us how great it is having exactly what you said, having this in one space. Because before it wasn't, I take it.
Oh, before it was in assorted barns, and we did rent a space for a while, but it was only 8-foot ceilings. You can't build a big set in eight-foot ceilings. And also, we had these transport trailers with our stuff in them, and you were trucking it through the snow to paint it. It was awful. Here, it's huge. It's got high ceilings. It's ready to roll. And the set for Honky Tonk Angels has been started in there. It's great.
You can tell the energy of this.
It's a vibrant organization. They have a lot of energy. They have a 10 show season coming up. And we welcome anyone who would like to volunteer with us. Just go on our website. Someone will get a hold of you.
Well, first of all, let me say how nice it is to repeat our town crier's words, to actually see people smiling, engaging, talking, conversation. I would say, first and foremost, thank you for taking time out of your schedule to be here to what I consider an important occasion today. Typically, however, I would tell you I would not be here on today because if things were normal in life, this is the day I'd make a trip up to see my father because this would be his birthday. But unfortunately, time passes and happy birthday, Dad. But based on that, I am available and free. And when I heard of this celebration at the Hub, I was beyond excited. You may not know this, but Frank is my curling buddy, or maybe his curling buddy, for the last 10 years. Yes, we curled, but I have to tell you, I know everything that's happened to you in the past 10 years of every aspect in terms of what's happening, what's not happening, the call, what we should be doing, what we could be looking for, and more importantly, grant money. But with that being said, I can tell you through Jack, the board of directors, the many, many volunteers, I'm proud to say we have had a long enduring relationship with your organization. And I expect with this council or future councils, that fabulous relationship will indeed continue. So again, on behalf of Cobra Council, senior staff, we'd like to bring congratulations to the Hub. I think it's a perfect name. We'll provide invaluable housing for your props, both big and small, as we noticed today. And you also created a clean and safe workspace moving forward. We wish Northumberland Players continued success. We know you're going to have success. And offer our thanks from the public, from the community, because all those posters means you have support from our community. And I thank you for a multitude of ways of entertaining us. I can't wait, and I have it in my pocket already, 2023, what you have yet to present. Congratulations and best wishes.
Through Facebook, a lot of you know that I was just at Fenway Park a little while ago, and I sat in those cheap seats way back there. Can you guys hear me in the woo-hoo, the green monster? Okay. Anyways, thank you so much. This is, I think, the best turnout we've had for our barbecue. I agree with Mandy that we're just have been dying to get together. She practically said my whole speech, so thank you very much. Thank you for all the dignitaries that have come. I saw people from the Capitol Theater, from the Best Western, all the people who support us, a couple of our sponsors are here, town councilors, I know it's easy, I know who to vote for, and this is an amazing night, and really, really proud. I just have to say this because this has been like giving a birth to a beautiful baby, because we've been trying to do this for so many years. If you just had seen some of the places that we were working, in you know, a shop where we couldn't even stand up an 8-foot flat, and most of our flats are 10 feet, in a shop where we couldn't paint, where people had to drag pieces of equipment from a container to the shop in the middle of winter, going to a barn to pick up half of our set and then moving it somewhere else. It's been crazy. And our volunteers have put up with that because they love theater and they're passionate about what we do. And that's probably what the most rewarding thing is, that we finally have a home to bring people together. And Peter, I think that's why I think that the money is really valuable, in the sense that that's what it does. It's more than the $50,000. It's about bringing a community together to one place. And as Victor started calling the place the hub of activity, and this is an indication of what's going to happen in the future, where people can come and, you know, exercise their creativity with the Northumberland Players. It makes me really, really proud in our 46th year of operation. So very proud. Please continue doing that. We have an amazing season that's coming up. I think we have a list of people we're gonna thank. But when we started doing this process 2 years ago, all right, we didn't have a space at all. We put face masks on 70 kids. We had our camp. We tried to pivot, that big fancy word, right? We managed to do outdoor theater. Hey, we never do outdoor theater. Let's try that. And the town of Colbert supported us in that as well. And 900 people showed up for that. Hey, maybe we do a dinner theater, but there's COVID going on. Why don't we have a show about with two couples? But yeah, they have to be married if they're they audition. So we did that. And we did a Christmas show, and I remember singing upstairs with masks on. And we did another dinner theater. Didn't quite get through that one, but crammed everything together and canceled 500 and did another show. And all those things are crazy. This year, for example, we did summer camp. 145 kids came to our summer camp. With no masks. And I don't think anybody got COVID, because we like have hospital, you know, system in there for breathing, for goodness sakes. It's amazing. So we are very grateful that we're seem to be back in action. And please use the opportunity to connect with people and make our comeback year a very memorable one. Thank you very much for everyone for being here.
Start building, so you can see they're building the pillars here, and this is what the Cool.
Yeah.
So then he's selling it, so we had to get out of there. And we were trying to figure out what we're going to do with all this furniture and stuff. So the builders came up with this scheme where you can create your own aisle and make use of space. It's smart. Things over.
And you can do it with one hand.
Yeah. Well, I'm really strong. When the designer and the decor person decides what furniture you need, they come in here and see if you have it. So then obviously there's sound and lighting. That's the added bonus for that.
Good.
Lots
more.
I'm going to make the kind of stairs. So.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know about the rest of the folks.
So this whole thing was the same thing. And we built this message to figure out what you need to decorate the set. And so they'll come and go through the inventory, and a number of the props have been made, a lot of them donated. This is not our current WGP. Yeah, so we have a bunch of shit. So Jenny Ryan's, you can see she's got everything organized and labeled.
Jenny Ryan's doing it. Wow,
Jenny's been responsible. And Fran Martin is in the show too.
Wow.
They were up here doing the tour, but you get me instead.
Well, that's okay. That's okay.
And, a lot of the props like here, we might get used in one or two different plays, but a lot of stuff waits and waits, but eventually. The design, and we encourage the designers to come and see what we
quite an impressive. This is great. Do you sometimes rent these out to other groups?
Yeah, so you can rent any of these costumes. This would be nice in summer.
Yeah, for an outdoor play.
Yeah, if you're in the Army, it's always wool.
You go through that door
right
ahead of you there.
There's lots of costumes that probably haven't used, but there's been costumes that have been used a number of times.
So. Since I've been there, we haven't really had productions on board from, but we did, like, for our Gandhi,
a couple of years ago, we did Sister Act, three or four, Sister Act,
Thank you.
Let's wake everybody up on this here bus and have us a hootenanny. Anybody want a bologna sandwich? I got a whole bunch. Okay, I know y'all know this one, so come on now. Let's raise the rafters. Delta Dawn, what's that flower you have on? Could it be a faded rose from days gone by? And did I hear you say he was a Nina today?
Thank you very much to Ben Carelli and the Trillium Foundation for making most of this building really possible. And the Cobourg Council members for all their support through the years.